grasp taught me was that it wasn't enough just to make it free. It wasn't enough just to build the tool. That you had a responsibility in sharing that tool. We had to build a self-instructional platform that would provide people with the means and the understanding, that would provide people with the structure and the direction for running their journals.
When lecturers came back with their PhDs, they found our libraries having no material to support their research interests, and they quickly rusted. So INASP came in into that space to help us access journals through cooperative agreements and subsidized access into those journals, because the greatest issue was the cost of journals.
INASP has come in to really build the research interest of a lot of people way back home. Because during the times when the economic situations were bad, people were not interested in research because they were not getting the information that they needed to carry on further research. But now everything is available. People are able to access this information.
I'll quote from Nelson Mandela, "Eliminating the distinction between the information rich and the information poor is critical to eliminating economic and other inequalities between the North and South."
Before I met Enas, like some 2 years or so ago, I didn't know anything about information literacy. Now I know about information literacy and actually built capacity of people in Ghana on information literacy. And so looking at what they have put in me, building my capacity in that regard, I see me myself as an achievement, and that is a plus for INASP.
I've been with AGEL for 6 years, and it's grown in leaps and bounds in those 6 years, but none of that would have been possible without what INASP did in the first place. And the fact that they've managed to take that fledgling project and then started again with various other JOL projects such as NEPJOL and LAMJOL, and those are all doing so well. I think it just shows that they're doing incredible things worldwide, not just within Africa. To be here today and to listen to the history of INASP and all the other projects and relationships that they've got going, it's incredible, and I think they're great.